We're over at Deva Boxing Club in Chester. I've been over here just watching Ricky Gorman sparring with Rob Cunningham, who's a bare knuckle boxer. Now, Rob, it's great to see you over
here.
Good
to meet you, mate. Thanks for taking some time to speak to me.
No, absolutely. No, it's good watching the sparring there. I don't know much about bare knuckle boxing, other than it's boxing with no gloves on.
That's it, mate, yeah.
And I know that you, Ricky was telling me that you fought for the British title in your first fight in bare knuckle, so you were straight in at the deep end. So tell us about it. Tell us about bare knuckle and, you know, you getting into it.
It sort of come by accident, mate, to be fair. I was a mixed martial artist, started training MMA when I was 26, and 33 now. Then during all the COVID lockdowns and stuff, there was no shows on anywhere unless it was your big boxing shows with Eddie Hearn or UFC and stuff like that. So a bare knuckle promotion approached me and said, do you want to fight on a behind closed doors show? We've got it all signed off for a British title. And I was like, yeah, why not? Let's see what it's about. So never boxed before properly, never really trained in boxing. It was all mixed martial arts. So yeah, sort of got thrown in against their number one heavyweight. He's a multiple time world champion now with them. So yeah, baptisms of fire. It's grown massively. I'm signed to Bare Knuckle Fighting Championships, which is the biggest promotion in the world. I got signed by them last summer. Fought in Wembley Arena down in London. They come over and did the first show in the UK. They were established 2018, so just to put it into sort of like scale on that, the first couple of shows they had 300-400 people. They sold out the Wembley Arena for 6,500. They're doing a show next month in America and it's got 9,000 sold out, so it's growing massively. Yeah, it's going to be huge, I believe. They're being bought out by Triller as well, who are a massive name in combat sports. So
yeah. Obviously, yeah, MMA has become very prominent over the years now. It's massive, and it's, you know,
yeah.
I mean, boxing has got its own sort of market, but you know, like you said, bare knuckle, people are wanting to see other combat sports now, and
it's new, it's fresh, it's something people haven't sort of seen before, except people think it might be like sort of a street fight or something like that. It's nothing like that. It's actually very safe. You don't suffer the trauma through the head that you do with gloves. It's surface damage mostly, cuts, breaks in the face and hands. But the feel we've got for it, it seems like it was like the UFC when the UFC took off. So it's going to be big. They've signed some massive names. They've just signed Austin Trout, former world champion boxer. They've got Diego Sanchez, who's in the UFC. They're currently in talks with Nate Diaz, who fought in the UFC. They've had Paige VanZant fight for them, Michael Venom Page, who fights for Bellator. They've got some really big names. Ben Rothwell, who is a title challenger in the UFC, that's the fight I'm chasing at the moment. So get myself a couple of wins and then I will get in there with Big Ben, hopefully over in America.
Have you done actual boxing as well?
Not really, no. I had like a charity exhibition thing when I was younger, and I've been in and out of boxing gyms doing sessions now and again, but I've never really took it serious. I didn't start training until I was 26 in anything. So I was sort of late, but being 33 now, I'm still a very young heavyweight. So a lot of the title holders in the BKFC are towards their 40s. So I've got 7 years, and if I can get 4 or 5 fights a year, I'll be working my way up that ladder towards the title, hopefully in the next couple of years.
So 26, you got into combat sports.
Yeah, man.
So what was you doing before that then?
Just normal lad, mate. Every weekend with mates. I used to play football when I was younger. Played an all right sort of local standard. Wasn't great at it. But I'd always had like followed boxing, followed mixed martial arts. And then I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna go down the gym and see if I can do it. And it was just to get fit first, because I knew the fitness level of it was brilliant. And then I got hooked on it, and then I was like, yeah, I'm quite good at this, so I want to test myself. The difference with me, when I was fighting, especially my amateurs in MMA, I was learning on the job. And everyone learns on the job, that's a bit of a silly thing to say, but I really was. Like, these guys that I was fighting were miles ahead of me in regards to experience. I'd fought guys that had been wrestling for 5 or 6 years, or Muay Thai fighters that had backgrounds, and I was brand new to it. Never thrown a punch in my life, except scuffles and that. It was just a brand new thing for me, so I was learning. I just wanted to get the cage time in, the rounds, and now I'm fighting for BKFC, who's the biggest, like I said, promotion in the world for bare knuckle. Bit of a mad 7 years, like.
What are the differences of boxing and bare knuckle? Obviously, these are no gloves, but you know the rules and that.
It's quite similar. They're 2 minute rounds instead of the 3 minutes. And they usually do five rounds, so they don't go obviously to the 10, 12 rounds like you do in the pros when you're on the higher end of the cards and stuff. There's still a knockdown rule. You can fight in the clinch, so you're allowed to sort of tie clinch and fight, which suits me because of the MMA. I actually think I won that last fight in the clinch because I landed on his body and then he quit in the corner. I landed an uppercut. I believe it was in the clinch right at the end of the second round and he gave up. So that sort of suits my game quite well with the clinch fighting. But in regards to everything else, it's quite similar. A lot of the better fighters in the BKFC, I've got good boxing pedigree. So Conor Tierney, a friend of mine, he's probably the biggest bare knuckle fighter in the country at the moment. He's headlining the show in London. He had a very good amateur boxing background. James Lilly, Tyler Goodjohn, who also fight for him, were very good boxers in their own right as well. So.
Yeah, I've a few boxers who have gone over to trying to bare knuckle as well. Are you getting quite a lot of that then? People, you know,
they're bringing in a lot of MMA guys are coming over to it.
Some of the names as well.
Yeah,
the big names.
Big names. Nate Diaz is in talks. Don't know if that's over the line or what. Mike Perry fights for him. Paige Van Zandt, who's got like a massive following. She fought for the UFC. Artem Lobov. Paulo Malignaggi fought for BKFC, so they've had some big names in there. They've got a big following, and it's only going to grow. Like, so I'm just happy to be part of it.
How do you get into it? How do people get into it? What was your route into it?
I got a message on Facebook, mate. I sent him a message a while ago, just off the cuff, saying if you never need a heavyweight at any time, I'm a heavyweight MMA fighter. Drop me a message and. I sort of got the reply back saying, you've got a British title fight if you want it. So it was quite mad. But I think with the BKFC, they want high caliber of fighter. So they prefer you to have a professional background or a good boxing pedigree. They're trying to attract the best fighters in the world because they want to put on the best fights. And they are, like even the guys that are sort of just pure bare knuckle fighters, they're the best in the world at doing it. So. But a lot of the guys they bring in are ex-boxers, ex-Muay Thai fighters, but they're top level. Over in Asia, they've got Sanchai fighting, who's one of the best Thai fighters ever, against Bukhao. They're fighting each other, and they're two of the best Thai boxers that have ever lived. So that's the caliber of sort of fighter they're bringing over.
Yeah. Watching you sparring there with Eddie Gorman, professional heavyweight. You know, I take it then when boxers come into the sport, compared to MMA, because it is stand-up, and the boxers obviously got that edge there. I mean,
it swings and roundabouts because the boxers obviously it suits them, and then the clinch work suits the MMA guys. So it's a mixture of both. A lot of the champions are ex-MMA guys at the moment, but I think the more higher caliber boxer they bring in, like Austin Trout's going to win a world title. He's that good. He was a boxing world champion, so. I think the more high caliber boxers that come into it, they'll win world titles as well.
Interesting. I was speaking to Tom Aspinall about that, and I asked him if he ever, when he was sparring with a boxer, does he ever get the urge to lift his legs up on his knees or kick or anything? So, and you know, he said he does actually. Yeah, yeah. What about you? Did you come from that?
Yeah, like when I first started it, even that first British title fight. A lot. I was in my head setting up kicks, leg kicks, because I used to leg kick quite a bit. But I'm out of that habit now because I've been doing this for just solely training in boxing for the last 12 to 18 months. So, definitely that urge was there to start. Like you think, oh, if I land a jab, I can throw a leg kick at him. But
he also said as well that you know against a boxer because it's a different type of footwork.
Oh yeah,
You can confuse a boxer who's. You know, he's got the traditional sort of style.
Yeah.
Someone who's a bit more unorthodox as well. So I suppose like the MMA, it's a mix of different styles and which makes it interesting. You've got your stand-up boxers and the ones who want to get stuck in.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
All the different styles.
Yeah, with the bare knuckle, there's pure boxers who want to work off the jab. you've got brawlers who just want to get in there and have a complete scrap with you and just last man standing. So that's why I've decided, well, I've asked Ricky to help me out, because there's no better caliber of heavyweight sparring in the country, in my opinion. He spars with the top people, works with Tom Aspinall, he works with, obviously he's related to Nathan Gorman and Tyson and that, so the pedigree's there. So when Augie said, drop him a message, get him down here to do some work here, it's only going to do me good. He's a hard man to hit, but I'll learn from it and I'll only get better.
You're taking a lot from these spars then. What are you taking out of them?
His head movement, his foot movement. When I've sparred other people, because I can impose my size on people, I usually land quite a bit. I walk forward and I usually connect with him. It's a different kettle of fish with Ricky. His head movement, he's just hard to get near. He knows, he's elusive, he knows how to get away with the shot. So that'll make me better, because when I come up against guys that can move, they won't move as well as him. So it's only going to benefit me, yeah. And he can bang.
Yeah, sparring for you. Yeah. And you were saying now, you know, you think he can do really well, Ricky, go all the way. I mean, you've been in there with him now a few times, and
yeah, he'll be a world champion. No doubt about it. He showed me some of his other sparring sessions with top guys in the country, boxers. Obviously, he's been in with Tom as well. There's no reason, he's only 26. He'll win British, Commonwealth, European, world title. There's no ceiling on it for him. I think he's that good.
He's talking to you now as well, aren't he? Helping you out a bit. Yeah. With stuff.
It's with the spars with him and the sessions. He'll say something if he sees something I'm not doing well. He went left hand up. I've got bad elbow, so I couldn't really get it up. But he was like, left hand up and work your jab. And then last week we did a lot of corner stuff, so he's helping me get out of the corner more and move better, because the boxing footwork's brand new to me. But he was stopping, and even when we're sparring, I try and take a split second if I get a chance to look at the way his feet are going, just so I can try and get it in my head. And then when we finished last week, he had me on the ladder doing different footwork stuff and that. So just his knowledge, he's a young man, but he's been around it since he was a little boy, so his experience is better than most people's, do you know what I mean? So to learn off him, to get rounds with him, it's just, I can't complain, mate, can I? It's the best I can get.
Yeah. You know, chatting out about the bare knuckle, the MMA, yeah. You know, they're really taking off. Boxing, you know, traditionally, it's been around for years, and you know, it's going through, as it having its moments, you know, at the moment, should I say.
Yeah.
And YouTube boxing is coming to the forefront a bit. What's your views on that? And what's your, as someone in another combat sport from the outside looking into boxing,
yeah,
how do you judge it and see the state of it?
I understand why fighters will fight these YouTubers like Jake Paul, because they're getting big paydays, but to be fair, he's actually quite good now. I can't diss him too much, because listen, that guy's got a lot of money. And for the last how many years, he's been able to pump all his money into his training. He probably trains three times a day with the best boxing coaches in the world. So he's going to get good, just like anyone else doing it. So I don't like it, though. It's just a bit, it's not really my cup of tea. I love boxing. I love watching the big fights and stuff. But sometimes it just makes you think, oh, what's going on here? It gets a bit silly. But there was an event the other week, it was on DAZN, and KSI was fighting someone who's never fought before, and there was a lot, it's just all about money, there's a lot of money involved in it, so I get it, but I don't like it that much.
I think it's splitting boxing, Rob, you know, it's like some are kind of accepting it, others
it's bringing a new fan base to. I suppose it's bringing different people in to watch it and that, but I don't know, doesn't take the boxes for me.
No. When in the boxing gyms you've got these pro boxers who are
worked their asses off to.
Yeah, and then.
But at the same time, if I got offered a fight for $2 million against a YouTuber, you'd be silly not to say yes to it, do you know what I mean? Yeah. So I understand why people take the fights. But I mean, the guy's Jake Paul's fault. You gotta remember, a lot of boxers when they start the pro careers, apart from Ricky, because no one will fight him, but for the first 10 fights you fight a lot of journeymen. Jake Paul's fought an ex-UFC world champion. Boxers wouldn't do that. Doesn't matter if he was past it or what, he fought Anderson Silva, who was considered the best MMA fighter in history, do you know what I mean? So you've got to take your hat off a little bit with him doing stuff like that. But it's when Floyd Mayweather's fighting the guy that's 0-1 an exhibition bet. Well, I just don't get the point in it. He's got enough money. It's like, you don't need to do it anymore. It's like, you're not 52-0 in my eyes, you're still 50-0. Even the Conor McGregor fight, it was like, I knew Floyd was going to win. I thought Conor did well, but I think Floyd let him do well. I think if Conor took boxing more seriously and it was his main sport instead of the MMA, I think he'd do well in it because he's a really good striker. I was a huge Conor McGregor fan, still am. He's one of my favourite fighters, regardless of what people say about him. What he did in mixed martial arts was unbelievable. And I think if he decided to become a boxer, I think he's one that would do well with it. And it wouldn't be like a YouTube boxer because he's a combat sports athlete. Yeah.
Well, Rob, remind us about your next fight, March, is it?
So yeah, BKFC, and BKFC UK have allowed me to take a fight with Gromda, as there's nothing available at the beginning of the year. So I'm going over to fight in Poland on the 3rd of March for Gromda, for a different promotion. And then I'm back in with the BKFC at the end of April in Liverpool. So that's the next one. So my managers had it all agreed with the UK promoter. It's all been ticked off to go out to Poland to fight. So I'm very grateful they've allowed me to do it. And then I'm back in with the BKFC in April as well. BKFC, I've got their own app. It's only £5 a month. You get the whole back catalogue of every show they've done. There's loads of content on there and all the shows are on that. So the BKFC fights, if you can't attend in Liverpool, download the app on your phone. It's £5 a month and there's like 30, 40 odd shows on there. So it's well worth the money.
Yeah. So sport's going from strength to strength and you're glad to be a part of it.
Yeah, I'm excited. It's a deep heavyweight division. There's a lot of good fighters there. Like I said, I've called it out a couple of times. I've spoke to my manager. I've put it online that I want the fight with Ben Rothwell, ex-UFC heavyweight. He's 1-0 in the sport. He's got a big MMA record, but it's bare knuckle. It's a different sport. I'm the only guy in the division the same size as him. So it makes sense to have the two biggest in the division fight. I think they're going to push him more towards title. He's ranked fifth already after one fight. I won and I'm not ranked fifth. But it's his name. He sells pay-per-views, sells tickets, so it's one of them. But that's the fight I want in the next 12 months. He can either come over to Wembley and fight me, or I'll go out to America and fight him.
Official call out then, eh, Rob?
Official call out, yeah. Big Ben versus Big Rob.
Let's get it on,
yeah.
Rob, great to meet you. And,
yeah, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, and I wish you all the very best going forward.
Thank you very much, buddy. Appreciate that.